Welcome to episode 814 of Saturday Night Comedy Shack. You might be wondering, why is this on a Sunday again? You were doing so good with on-time uploads, you stupid fucking asshole. And I'm gonna tell you, it's because that was always planned. You simpleton. You should pay attention. Always planned to have a Friday and a Sunday Saturday Night Comedy Shack upload because I didn't want one right after the other. Now that's not a policy I've normally done. I actually have normally just done it back to back if that happens, but I decided to not do that this time. Anyway, for this episode we have a wide variety of things, including sports content, Minority Report on Xbox, people being beaten to death, possibly in multiple locations. Cody Rhodes will be on the program. And so much more. If that all sounds like fun to you, then please come on in. If it doesn't, I'll get the fuck out. Seems pretty simple to me. Okay. So last time I got a little upset. Let's do this right this time. I mean, it was a little bit of half and half, actually. I actually did get kind of upset and annoyed, but since it was April Fool's Day, I took the opportunity to just bypass the whole fucking thing. This feels like a fucking cheat code. I actually had to look up how to fucking do this, and I... Okay, first of all... I want this. Couldn't hurt. It's the end of the fucking game now. No. We're not gonna need those. Seriously? What a fucking whore. I'm using the wasp launcher next time. Fuck that. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I made an uncalculated error last time. We're going to buy this now. Buy this now. And just hope for the best. This honestly feels like... It feels like I'm cheating. Feels like switch the grenade launcher, actually. Fuck, I think I'm already fucked. Yep, alright, so we're gonna take out the wasp launcher. Oh, I'm gonna be so fucking mad. No! I fucking don't! Damn it!
John, we can fix this. We can make you a cop again.
Why should I believe you? I spent the last 2 days running away from you.
Give the lady her hat. Now, John.
It's a start. Wait here. I have something to take care of.
Yours.
You can't give me what I want.
But you can't kill me.
Shut up.
Well, that's cool and all. I don't care. That's that. That's the game. Maybe next time we can. I made no promises, but next time maybe we can try one of those Hall of Pains or whatever the fuck they were called. But as far as the main game goes, we're done, so that's good. And I've locked myself into one more commitment with it, and after that I can never see this fucking game again. So that's pretty fucking great. Moving on!
And he creates some confusion for a defense, how he is going to be utilized, and then also how they're going to determine personnel defensively. We've seen Pittsburgh tonight, at times they've treated him as a receiver. They've gone to their five defensive backs. At other times they've stayed base personnel. But he creates matchup problems for any defense. They fake it to him. Mayfield now throws it to him. And a loss on the play is the rookie Devin Bush.
Oh, God, that was terrible. That play made me want to die. More than usual, so frankly, I'm impressed in a way. But, you know.
To take Devin Bush as the number 10 pick in this last draft.
Doesn't change that I still want to hang myself after seeing that football play.
An awfully good player, and he's just scratching the surface on his potential, and they haven't used him entirely the way that they intend to in talking with Mike Tomlin. Third down and 11, passes high.
That was awful.
Beckham was the target, and the closest one to it was Steven Nelson. Well, I don't know if that's because Baker Mayfield had people in his face.
Okay, let's... it's not going to show us that, but...
of where Odell Beckham was going to be.
Seems like he's about a yard and a half off.
Petonio,
maybe 2 yards, 3 yards.
That should be in this league. That should be an easy completion. Would have been a first down. And that's what they have to be able to iron out. That between Mayfield and Beckham here in their first year together.
That almost blocked. Oh, God.
At the 9 by Taki Taki. This is earlier in the ballgame at the end of that 42-yard reception with the reaction by Odell Beckham. Now Beckham and Tomlin kind of come together. That yawning, people believe, is in reference to Mike Tomlin over the offseason being asked about having to play Odell Beckham Jr. twice with individual play, and he yawned about it. And that obviously got Beckham's attention. That was his reaction. Beckham's after the 42-yard play. Here's an interception by Schobert. This could end the night. Spun down inside the 5 by Mason.
Holy Rudolph. Dick wipes. I looked away for a second. I actually completely forgot to cut away. But you know what? Thankfully, I didn't fucking bother. Because... oh, I'm so fucking glad that I dropped Mason Rudolph on my fantasy team. I don't have to rely on him anymore because, Jesus Christ, he was one inconsistent piece of shit. He did enough to not lose me games twice, but... and then I had to trust that dumb asswipe Jimmy Garoppolo, but that's a matter of another time. I guess it doesn't matter now because you're seeing this in 2020 or whatever, but still. Yeah, we can go ahead and just cut away now, because I forgot to cut away after the punt, but who cares? Who cares now? Okay, it's time to talk about The Simpsons. For real this time. Though, honestly... The joke review is not all that far off from what I'm actually going to say. Because it sucked. It sucked. Brandine finds out she likes learning. Or was she already liking learning? And then we have some stupid subplot with Lisa that's essentially the same thing. Well, no, hang on. Let me back up, because this is actually dumber than what I'm trying to describe here. Okay, so the episode begins with everybody at the book club at Marge's house, Brandine included, and all the other fucking neighbor Springfield women. And Brandine says something intelligent after everyone says that they don't like the book, and everybody's shocked for some reason, even though this book club has been going on for a while now, apparently. Never mind. And then Cletus finds out, and there's a whole thing about that, and also in the episode is Lisa doing a book report on some bullshit that I don't care about. It's not important, doesn't come up again. And then some incognito smart kids who we've never seen before at any point recruit her to become a part of their elite circle jerk. But the catch is they have to hide being intelligent, which is what Brandine's doing. And at the end of the episode, everybody stops hiding. And, yeah. And there was no profound, and there, I mean, a profoundly good joke from The Simpsons is not, that's not gonna happen, and it hasn't happened in at least 20 years, but there's no joke that really sticks with you in any way, shape, or form. It all just kind of sucked. I think this might have actually been offensive noise, because it hurt my feelings with how little they gave a fuck. It wasn't quite as bad as the episode I turned off once, where Marge was pretending to be a drag queen to sell Tupperware. But I just didn't fucking care. I just didn't fucking care. I sat through the whole episode. It was a nice time with me and my dogs that we were sitting on the couch. Or chair, actually. That part wasn't very relaxing, but it was relaxing for them, so, sitting on the chair, watching the program, and they had a nice time. They fell asleep right quick, and I wish I could have joined them, because that would have been more engaging and more productive. Is there a new episode of The Simpsons coming up? I don't know, but if there is, we'll be back to talk about it. If there's not, please God. Hello, welcome to the Bill and Randy Show. Today, for some stupid fucking reason, we have to play Duke Nukem Zero Hour on the Nintendo 64. I think it has something to do with the wretched sport of college basketball. But I don't know. I don't know. I couldn't fucking tell you. I think it's some rotten fucking pun about Duke being eliminated from the fucking Final Four. Fuck college basketball.
Travel technology. based. Oh, fuck off. Do they both go to the same place? Touchy. You crouch. Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Oh. It looks really good. But that's the point, isn't it? It looks good. Bitch. I think playing the training area by mistake actually served to our benefit, because I'm fairly certain that if I can't do this properly, Bill, then there's no fucking way I'll be able to do anything important properly. Come on, Duke. Stop being a fucking panty waste. Oh my god, you can't run and jump. It's not physically possible with these fucking controls. It's like you have to run to where you want to start the jump, press the jump button, wait forever, and then hope this stupid fucking asshole will land where you want it to land. Fucking god. I'm giving it one more fucking try. After that, fuck it. Fuck this. God is dead, Bill. God is dead, and games like this is why. Alright, fuck it. I hope everybody at Three Realms responsible for this game was brutally molested by a clown named Carlos. You hear me, you cunts? That is all. Moving on. Let's have a match. Multiple. Our first match will be Scott Steiner taking on Booker T. in the Media Center. Bitch. He's putting on a real clinic in wrestling tonight. Drop kick. Another one for the good guy. DDT. How much punishment can one human being endure? Double axe handle. Front suplex. What are we going to see next?
Now that's how you deliver that.
A great match. Oh, that wasn't good.
Kids, don't try that at home. You know, that's what I do, Shivani. If you push me too far, I'd knock you out.
Oh,
tearing this place apart. It was as if he was dropped from a self-bomber.
Looks like he's a bit unbalanced after that one.
He's turned this into an all-out brawl.
He sure has, Tony. Oh yeah, WrestleMania was tonight, wasn't it? Well, I know the next match is going to be.
Wow. These moves are only successful if
No. That'll be Cody Rhodes taking on Hulk Hogan. Oh, God damn it. Oh, okay, whatever. I thought I had the other one. And they're gonna have a tussle in the parking garage. A perfect match for Cody Rhodes.
I can't believe it. That was incredible. Good diamond cutter. You only see a move like that in WCW, folks. From out of nowhere. That was amazing. Oh, my goodness.
Die, Hulk Hogan. Lick my fucking taint, Hogan.
Good diamond cutter! Devastating impact by player one. Somebody's gonna get a heavy bill for this carnage. Wow, I hope that he remembered to replace that divot. Oh my, something's going on here! He took a nasty hit there. Don't take that. Punch him, kick him. Body slam! Great move by player one. Leave that alone. This isn't a riot. So much for that object. Flying body press. How much longer before this wrestler admits defeat? His opponent cannot even catch his breath. He has full control. Close line. Look how hurt he is. Someone call the match off. That's blood. That's blood. The match is over.
Well, that was fun. Moving along! It's actually a little better for once that we have this little buffer here. So, here's part one of the commercial break. Then part two, we're going to go to the originally scheduled Discord ad. We gotta advertise an issue that's going on over the YouTube channel and could potentially spill over to Twitch. Triple H is getting fucking pissed. They keep getting this bullshit double count-out nonsense. So, for, So, to hype up that match, we're going to have Triple H and the man who I can't fucking believe he returned to wrestle at WrestleMania, honestly. It's been so fucking long, I never thought it would happen. Not that I watched the match. Unfortunately, I was busy, but I'll watch it eventually. It'll be Triple H and Stone Cold Steve Austin in a reuniting of the two-man power trip, taking on Dude Love and newly minted WWE Hall of Famer, The Undertaker, in a First Blood Tornado tag match, ahead of Monday night's steel cage confrontation between the two. Or possibly Tuesday night, I don't know. It depends when this gets released. Because, you know, we're a little later into this process now. I'm not entirely sure when it's going to be released. You get the point, though. If Saturday Night Comedy Shack says it's uploaded on Monday, expect the match on Tuesday. If it's uploaded on Sunday, like it's supposed to be, expect it on Monday. Triple H is real fucking tired of these countouts. So now he demanded a match inside a steel cage with Dude Love, where the only way to win is by running away. Does it make a lot of sense? Not really, but it would lead to no outside interference, and it would lead to a clean victory, at least. So is that what the result going to be on Monday or Tuesday? Probably not, because there's no knockouts. But y'all know what I mean. And I can't answer that. You'll just have to come in and find out on the next episode of PS2 Gaming. Since even if we get back to streaming on Twitch that day, I wouldn't do the Gran Turismo Championship match then. Anyway.
Hey. Normally what I would do here is do a Twitch ad. However, I feel like we have not been shilling the Discord enough. So here it is in the desktop version. Come on in to see the lovely conversations that are had and me marking out about things. Small community now, but you can join the fun. You'll get updates on every Twitch stream, because I always made sure to post those, every YouTube link, which I have not been doing a great job at. Suggest games to play on Twitch. Ignore this one. This one's not important to anybody right now. You can hang out and listen to music and shit. And I don't think this one's been used yet, actually. But just as well. Link in the description. The invite doesn't expire. I made sure of that after somebody corrected me.
Hello, this is an edition of Frank's Project. However, I realized I didn't actually do a little preamble before it. What we're going to be testing here is to see how Vegas and Windows Movie Maker play nice with each other. Now, you might think you already did that.
not in the way that you're going to see. So, here we go. And if it works, it works. If it doesn't, well, we'll know.
Look, Pim, I know it's our job to help this guy and everything, but I think this guy's a lost cause. He's obviously made up his mind. Why don't we just cut our losses and get out of here?
Hello. Welcome to things that piss Jason off. I kind of had to do this now because I don't know if they were going to fix this problem later, but let me tell you, it really fucking pisses me off now. First, I need some draft picks. Oh, wait, I might actually have some. Oh, whatever. Fuck it. This will add to the misery, I guess. You'll see. Might as well just let him fucking play out. My fault anyway. Fine, beat his ass again. Like I fucking care. Oh, good lord, no wonder the kid sitting... Good lord, no wonder the little kid sitting next to me at NXT TakeOver Portland thought they were the same person. Oh my god, I never noticed that till now. Wow, holy shit. They really do look really fucking alike when you put them next to each other. All right, now, my asshole was primed and puckered, waiting for that fucking 24/7 championship thing to come up. Might as well use them all. Yep. Cool, exclusive draft pitch. Alright. Load it up. Yep. Every single fucking time since the 24/7 championship mode update, this has happened. And it irks me to no fucking end. Because it's not like it's a difficult thing to fix. Just go back into the game, it fucking starts with the exclusive draft pick screen, you pick one. Here, I'll pick one now. Zoe start, cool, great. And then we go about our fucking business. I don't need the card, so I'll just fucking dust it off. But, god damn it.
Why? Why did you have to break this? And you had multiple updates to fix it in the meantime. You had an update on fucking Wednesday. And an update to get the fucking, the new tier in. You had time to fix this. Please is not doing the bullshit anymore where it shows the wrong number of games played. That was infuriating. But I got that on camera. Camera, quote unquote. But, fuck. This really does just annoy the fuck out of me. This is not bullshit, this is not conjecture, it actually does annoy the shit out of me. That this happens every single fucking time. Now if you'll excuse me.
Yeah.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all shit, age, sizes, and such purposes, let me introduce you your main event of the evening. I didn't want to try that. You know, get the proper experience. Okay, all right. This is a stealth mission. How I aim. Okay. So this is basically just fucking Nightfire shit. Or actually, this feels more like your Agent Underfire. Alright. Well, I'm switching back to the proper... I'm switching back to the controls God intended later. I do prefer that, though. I like that swear. It does feel really weird to have two different sets of controls, but it almost feels like two different fucking games. Wait, was I supposed to go this way? Or was I supposed to use this? I must have had to go this way. I should have done this right before today, actually.
Hey,
Damn it. Yeah, I'm switching back to the proper controls later. Fuck this. I know this is the way the game was originally made, but God, this fucking sucks. When you don't have to have it as an option. Damn it, already? That's a little concerning. Is this a fucking joke? Thank you.
it.
Too used to fucking L2 now. I see now. What the fuck was that? I better get the fuck out of here.
Thank you.
sabotage those cars so we can't be followed. Sabotage those cars so we can't be followed.
Fuck off. What do I gotta do it? Oh, shit. Not clear yet.
Anywhere until you clear the area of Germans. I don't want them to see my truck.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Where's the last one? This is supposed to be a mermaid? So, located in the back of the laundry truck by the mermaid fountain. Laundry truck. This is all I see. Was it at a different location entirely?
Let's get moving.
Oh. Boy, this is a pain in the ass. Thank you. Oh. I don't know where I'm getting shot from.
Be able to find a uniform and blend in. Thank you.
gotta be someone on the rooftop that just don't know where. There always is. God, this shit's long. Was I supposed to spill beer here? I'm confused now. spill some beer. How do I do that? Gentlemen. I headed upstairs. Oh. Keep doing it. Okay, I did that. What do I do now? Just watch it. I feel like I'm stuck here. God, that was fucking annoying. Let's turn this shit off. Alright, I'm gonna wait for that to save, and then we will go. That was your main event. Please leave. Now. Okay, is it still saving? What are we doing here? Okay, it's done.